Hello, and welcome to the Children's Sermon. Today I have a story for us. It's Maybe God Is Like That Too. It is written by Jennifer Grant. I gotta move my chair a little bit. This will be better. Okay. I live in the city where the sidewalks and subway cars and buildings and buses are packed with people, but I've never seen God before. Grandma, does God live in the city? I asked one morning at breakfast. Yes, God is here, she says. You just need to know where to look. Whenever you see love, joy, and peace, God is there, she says, stirring her tea. Wherever there's patience, kindness, and goodness, God is there too. When you see faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control, that's God's Spirit at work. On the way to school, I'm on the lookout. I see a bus full of tourists and count 10 bright yellow taxis. I spy a man sweeping a stoop, and Grandma and I laugh when we see a tiny dog wearing a fluffy purple sweater. At school, Grandma hands me my lunch and hugs me close before she says goodbye. That's what love looks like to me. Maybe God is like that too. On the swings, I pump so hard I see over the wall into the alley. My friends shout, "Higher, higher," as my feet fly way up into the sky. That's what joy looks like to me. Maybe God is like that too. Outside, car horns blast and sirens scream, but my classroom is quiet and calm. That's what peace looks like to me. Maybe God is like that too. I try to tie my shoes, but the laces tangle around my fingers. My teacher sits down beside me and shows me how to tie them. That's what patience looks like to me. Maybe God is like that too. On the way home, I see a doorman wearing a red cape and a hat with a shiny brim. He's holding the door for a man using a wheelchair. The man moves very slowly, and the doorman chats with him and smiles. That's what kindness looks like to me. Maybe God is like that too. While I'm setting the table for dinner, there's a knock at the door. It's our neighbor from downstairs bringing us a loaf of bread. It's golden brown and warmed, wrapped in a thin white towel. That's what goodness looks like to me. Maybe God is like that too. After dinner, I work on my homework while Grandma stands at the kitchen sink washing dishes and humming to herself, just like she does every single night. That's what faithfulness looks like to me. Maybe God is like that too. At bedtime, Grandma sits at the edge of my bed, singing me a lullaby and stroking my head. She tucks my blankets up close around me. That's what gentleness looks like to me. Maybe God is like that too. I lie in bed, watching the curtains flutter. I want to talk about that dog we saw today and how high I can swing, but Grandma says that once I'm tucked in, I have to stay in bed until morning. I close my eyes and try to fall asleep. That's what self-control looks like to me. Maybe God is like that too. I saw God over and over again today. Whenever I saw love, joy, and peace, and wherever there was patience, kindness, and goodness. When I saw faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control, I saw God's Spirit at work. I don't see God the way I see my friends, or the streetlights, or the river, but I see signs of God's Spirit all around me, right here in the city. I know what God is like. Maybe I can be like that too. In our first reading today from 1 Kings, we hear the story that Elijah is looking for God. Elijah's a little scared, and he runs away to look for God, and he has a hard time finding God. But God promises that he is there. And he says, "Come look for me." So there's a great big wind, and Elijah listens into the wind, but he doesn't find God. And then there's a great big earthquake, and Elijah looks for God, but Elijah doesn't find God. And then there's a great big fire, and Elijah looks for God, but God isn't there. And finally, there is just sheer silence and stillness. And that's where Elijah finds God. It's different from how people found God before. Moses found God in fire and wind and earthquake, and people found God in different ways, and Elijah finds God in the sheer silence. And so when Elijah talks to God, God promises that he is there, and that he will be with him always, and that he is not alone. And so right now, it might be hard for us to find God, to hear God, to listen for God, to see God. It might be a little harder than normal because we're not meeting in the church building and we're not around people like we were before. But like the book reminds us, when we see acts of kindness and gentleness, and when we see peace, and when we see people being faithful, God is there. That's how God is for us. God promises that just like with Elijah and just like in the story, God is with us always, and that we can see God everywhere when we go looking for him. Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for being with us always, and help us to see you in the world. Thank you for sending your Son to show yourself to us. In his name we pray. Amen. Thank you for coming, and I hope you have a great week.